Yeah, this is a keeper, but this is the kind of hand that just gets owned by Stoneforge Mystic very, very badly. Needs some Tumble Magnets or Inquisition. Well, let's see what he's got. Well, actually, let's not. He might think we have Inquisition, but the reason I didn't want to duress there is because if he plays Stoneforge, I'd rather just duress the sword on turn two. If he plays Hawk, I don't really care. Hawk is okay, and I've certainly died to just Hawks before, but for the most part, it's not really that big of a problem. Even if he gets a whole squadron. All right. Play another Darkseid Shores. Again, ship the turn. Maybe I should start keeping some like one landers or no landers with this deck. It seems like every draw step I get to peel another land. I'm really, really unlucky, as it turns out. He's gonna bash for one, and he may or may not play another Hawk, depending on what's in his hand. If he doesn't have a spell pierce, maybe he wants to leave Mana Leak up. I didn't duress this turn either because I can negate a sword if he plays it. I'd rather, again, wait till probably next turn I'm gonna be duressing. All right, yeah, sword is definitely getting negated, and now I have to duress to make sure he doesn't play a Jace. Lead with Inquisition, I suppose. Mana Leak, Preordain, and two Hawks. All right, well, we're gonna take Mana Leak and Preordain with our hand removal here. Leaving him with just some Hawks and. He's gonna play two Hawks this turn. We're gonna hopefully play a sweet card on our next turn, but if not, play Kalitha Forgemaster in a few turns. So he's got two Hawks and a Tech Edge and a card we did not know. Tech Edge is unfortunately gonna delay the appearance of the Forgemaster, though I don't really even have any artifacts to sacrifice to him yet, so that's not that big of a deal. Let's see if he drew a counterspell. And he possibly did. And we're drawing a Tezzeret. Well, if he drew a counter, he drew a counter. I can't really play around it. I mean, I've got all expensive cards, so waiting on them is, and when I'm getting attacked is really not really worth it. All right, I can't really help that. I mean, I stripped his hand of nothing, and then he peeled to stop the card I peeled. I'm most likely getting tech edged here, and then, oh no, he's got a Jace too. All right, yeah, Owen is much more skillful than Matt Nass. That is apparent. So, I think we're pretty dead here. I mean, I'm going to play a Forge Master, but he can just bounce it with Jace, and Forge Master doesn't really do that much anyway. Tezzeret. Yeah, Tezzeret's going to be the play. And going to be plus one again. Well, given my options are Bladesteel Colossus and Forge Master, I will take the Forge Master. And play land. So this still looks pretty bad. Not having an artifact to send to Jace is rough. And he can attack Tezzeret down to two, play another Hawk, brainstorm, do whatever. I think active Jace is just not gonna end up being good for me, despite the fact that I ended up resolving a Tezzeret. We'll see, I guess, but I do not have high hopes for this game, especially since he knows I have Forge Master, so he could, very easily have Mana Leak in his hand or something along those lines. Attack Tezzeret down to two, play another Hawk to kill Tezzeret next turn. And then, I don't know. Looks like he's playing a Gideon. All right. Gideon does it too. Gideon and plussing it. Oh, that was timely. Well, let's plus one Tezzeret. Mindslaver? Ooh, there we go. Mindslaver. I mean, I'm going to lose Tezzeret, but Mindsliver actually gives me slightly like a prayer of a chance here, since now I can get some action going. Maybe like basically mind twist him, make him Gideon one of his Hawks. If he doesn't use Tech Edge, though he probably will. Tech Edge is Colonnade. I mean, I still think I'm going to lose this game, but Mindsliver at least gives me a chance to have some fun before I do so. All right, he's going to go ahead and brainstorm. Well, he only has access to seven cards. I mean, what could he possibly have? And slam down a Colonnade in order to kill Tezzeret. It's probably then. Oh no, I guess he's just bashing me because he could have killed Tezzeret anyway. And then I guess he's going to Tech Edge one of my lands since definitely doesn't want to let me Mindslaver him with Tech Edge in play. So I take eight. There's only for some way for Gideon to kill himself. Unfortunately, there is not. I take 8, and then, yeah. Alright, well, let's slaver him and see what's going on. Come on, mortar pod. That'd be sweet. Land. Squadron Hawk. Well, I'm not going to get in here without brainstorming with Jace, I don't think. So let's go ahead and start with that. Hawk. Well, isn't that wonderful? So at this point, it looks like my best option is to put back Hawks. That doesn't really even... Or put back two land, cast a Hawk to make him... And make cast both Hawks and make him not shuffle. Can do that, and then I can attack with one Hawk and force him to kill it with Gideon. Can't... I mean, I could... Yeah. Alright, I guess that's... fine. Then he has four Hawks in play, and I'm... I think I'm actually just dead here. If I make him have four Hawks, no matter what, at the end of his turn, he's gonna... Even if I don't make him cast any Hawks this turn, he ends up with Colonnade, Gideon, and two Hawks, which is pretty lethal. So, yeah. I am not going to waste my time. Need him to draw something real sweet there. Go for the Throat does kill Gideon, but... I guess it's slightly better than Disfigure in that regard. I don't really see anything else I really want to take out. I mean, again, it's all about Jace. He resolved the Jace. When I, you know, I've got Negate, Spell Pierce, 2 Duress, and then all my Planeswalkers to stop his. And so...